beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. All things were made by Him, and without Him there was not anything made that was made. John chapter 1, verse 1 to 3. For He spake, and it was done. Psalms 33, verse 9. I had not seen, nor ear heard, nor has it entered into the heart of man, the things which God had prepared for them that love Him. But God has revealed them to you by His Spirit. For the Spirit searches all things, yes, the deep things of God. So let this mind be in you, which was in Christ Jesus, who being in the form of God, thought it not robbery to be equal with God. For it is God that worketh in you, both to will and to do of His good pleasure. So let your light shine before men, that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. And in that day you shall ask me nothing. Verily, verily, I say unto you, all things that you ask the Father strictly and directly from inside my name shall be given to you. So far you have not done this. Ask without hidden motive, and be surrounded by your answer. Be enveloped by what you desire, and let your joy be full. Therefore I say unto you, whatsoever things you so desire, when you pray, believe that you receive them, and you shall have them. Keep your heart with diligence, for out of it springs the issues of life. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run in and are saved. Therefore, I remind you to stir up the gift of God which is in you through the laying of my hands. For God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power, of love, and a sound mind. You will also declare a thing, and it will be established for you, so that light will shine on your ways when they cast you down, and you see, exaltation will come, and He will save you, the humble person. He will deliver one who is not innocent. Yes, you'll be delivered by the purity of your hands. But without faith, it is impossible to please Him. For he who comes to God must believe that He is, and that He is a rewarder of those who diligently seek Him. Though you walk through the valley of the shadow of death, you will fear no evil. Do not despise the chastening of the Lord, but detest His corrections. For whom the Lord loves, He corrects, just as a father the son in whom he delights. But I say to you, love your enemies, and pray for those who persecute you, so that you may be sons of your Father who is in heaven. For He makes His sun rise on the evil and on the good, and sends rain on the just and on the unjust. For if you love those who love you, what reward do you have? Do not even the tax collectors do the same? And if you greet only your brothers, what more are you doing than others? Do not even the Gentiles do the same? You therefore must be perfect, as your heavenly Father is perfect. which surpasses all understanding, we guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. You keep him in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on you, because he trusts in you. Isaiah 26, verse 3. It is God who arms you with strength and makes your way perfect. You can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. Jesus has said, all authority has been given to him in heaven and on earth. God gives power to the weak, and to those who have no might, he increases strength. He is your rock and your salvation. He is your defense. You should not be moved. In God is your salvation and your glory, the rock of your strength, and your refuge is in God. God is your refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, you will not fear, even though the earth be removed, and though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea, though its waters roar and be troubled, though the mountains shake with its swelling. You will boldly say, the Lord is my helper, I will not fear. What can man do to me? Blessed is the man who walks not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stands in the path of sinners, nor sits in the seat of the scornful. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law he meditates day and night. He should be like a tree planted by the rivers of water, that brings forth its fruit in its season, whose leaf also shall not wither, and whatever he does shall prosper. The Lord is your shepherd, you shall not want. He makes you lie down in green pasture. He leads you beside the still waters. He restores your soul. He leads you in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though you walk through the valley of the shadow of death, you fear no evil, for God is with you. His rod and his staff, they comfort you. He prepares a table before you in the presence of your enemies. He anoints your head with oil, and your cup runs over. And surely, goodness and mercy shall follow you all the days of your life, and you shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. For in him you live, move, and have your being. Restore health to you and heal you of your wounds, says the Lord. Surely he has borne our griefs and carried our sorrows. Yet we esteemed him stricken, smitten by God, and afflicted. For he was wounded for our transgressions, he was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement for our peace was upon him, and by his stripes we are healed. Behold, God will bring to you health and healing. He will heal you and reveal to you the abundance of shalom and truth. Then your light will break forth like the morning. Your healing shall spring forth speedily, and your righteousness shall go on before you. The glory of the Lord shall be your rear guard. you out of your distress. He sends his word and hears you, and delivers you from destruction. The Lord will strengthen you on your bed of illness. He will sustain you on your sick bed. So you shall serve the Lord your God, and he will bless your bread and your water, and he will take sicknesses away from the midst of you. Lord my God, I cried out to you, and you healed me. Psalms 30 verse 2. You have no struggles. Your bodies are healthy and strong. You are free from the burdens common to man. You are not plagued by human ills. You shall call upon me, and I will answer, says the Lord God of hosts. God heals the brokenhearted and binds up their wounds. Psalms 147, verse 3. God gives power to the faint, and to them that have no might, he increases strength. Isaiah 40, 29. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. Who forgives your iniquities, who heals all your diseases, who redeems your life from destruction, who crowns you with loving kindness and tender mercies, who satisfies your mouth with good things, so that your youth is renewed like the eagles. Psalms 103, verse 2 to 5. And this sign shall follow those who believe. In his name, they will cast out demons. They will speak with new tongues. They will take up serpents. And if they drink anything deadly, it will by no means hurt them. They will lay hands on the sick, and they will recover. If the Son therefore makes you free, you are free indeed. But if the Spirit of him who raised Jesus Christ from the dead dwells in you, he who raised Christ from the dead will also give life to your mortal bodies through his Spirit who dwells in you. Is anyone among you suffering? Let him pray. Is anyone cheerful? Let him sing psalms. Is anyone among you sick? Let him call for the elders of the church, and let them pray over him, anointing him with oil in the name of the Lord. And the prayer of faith will heal the sick, and the Lord will raise him up. And if he has committed sins, he will be forgiven. For God has not given you the spirit of fear, but of power, of love, and of a sound mind. So wait on the Lord. Be of good courage, and he will strengthen your heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord. Say, the Lord is my strength and my shield. My heart trusted in him, and I am helped. Therefore my heart greatly rejoiceth, and with my song will I praise him. Cast your burden upon the Lord, and he will sustain you. He will never suffer the righteous to be moved. You lay down, you sleep, and you awaken, for the Lord sustains you. Who himself bore our sins in his own body on the tree, that we, having died to sin, might live for righteousness, by whose stripes you were healed. Heal me, O Lord, and I shall be healed. Save me, and I shall be saved, for you are my praise. For I will restore health to you and heal you of your wounds, says the Lord. But to you who fears God's name, the Son of Righteousness shall rise with healing in his wings, and you shall go out and grow fat like stall-fed calves. If you diligently heed the voice of the Lord your God and do what is right in his sight, give ears to his commandments and keep all his statutes, none of the diseases will come on you which were brought upon the Egyptians. For he is the Lord who heals you. Surely he has borne our griefs and carried our sorrows. Yet we esteemed him stricken, smitten by God, and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement for our peace was upon him, and by his stripes we are healed. Lord, God will bring to you health and healing. He will heal you and reveal to you the abundance of peace and truth. Then your light shall break forth like the morning. Your healing shall spring forth speedily, and your righteousness shall go forth before you. The glory of the Lord shall be your rear guard. You cry out to God in your trouble, and he saves you out of your distresses. He sends his word and heals you, and delivers you from all destructions. No weapon formed against you shall prosper, and you have victory over every courtroom lie. But this is the heritage of the servants of the Lord. Lift up your eyes to the hills. From where does your help come from? Your help comes from the Lord, maker of heaven and earth. He will not let your foot slip. He who guards you does not slumber. Behold, the guardian of Israel neither slumber nor sleeps. The Lord is your guardian. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun will not strike you by day, and the moon by night. The Lord will guard you from all harm, will guard your life. The Lord will guard your going and coming, now and forevermore. You live in the shelter of the Most High, and therefore dwell in the shadow of Shaddai, the Almighty. Say always of the Lord, he is your strength and stronghold. Your God, in whom you always trust. For he will save you from the fowler's snare and from deadly plague. With his pinions, he will cover you. Need his wings, you will find shelter. His loyalty is an encircling shield. You need not fear terror by night, nor the arrow that flies by day, nor the plague that stalks in darkness, nor disease that ravages at noon. 1,000 may fall beside you, 10,000 at your right hand, but it will not come near you. You will only look with your eyes and see the punishment of the wicked. For you, the Lord is your refuge, for you have made the Most High your abode. No harm will befall you. No sickness will come near your home, for he will give his angels charge concerning you to guard you in all your ways. They will lift you up in their hands, lest your foot stumble on a stone. You will tread over lions and vipers. You will trample on young lions and snakes. Because he loves me, I will rescue him, says the Lord. I will protect him, because he acknowledges my name. And you see, you will call on him, and he will answer you. He will be you and bring you honor. With long life, he will satisfy you and show you his salvation. May the Lord answer you in times of trouble. By the name of Jacob's God, protect you, protect you. May he send you help from the sanctuary and support from Zion. May he recall all your grain offerings and accept all your burnt offerings. May he give you your heart's desire and ensure that your plans succeed. That we will shout for joy at your salvation and raise a banner in our God's name. May the Lord grant all your requests. Now I know that the Lord saves his anointed. He answers him from his holy heaven with the saving power of his right hand. Some trust in chariot, others in horses, but we call upon the name of the Lord our God. They crumple and fall, but will rise and stand firm. Lord, grant victory. May the King answer us when we call. O Lord, our Master, how mighty is your name in all the earth. Your majesty extends across the heavens. From the cools of little ones and babes, you founded power against your foes, slicing enemies and avengers. When I behold your heavens, the work of your fingertips, the moon and stars that you design, what are mortals that you should be mindful of them? Yet you have set them just below God and crowned them with glory and splendor. You've made them rulers over your handiwork and set it all beneath their feet. All flocks and herds, beasts of the field, birds of the skies, and fish of the sea, whatever travels the path of the seas. O Lord, our Lord, O Lord, our Master, how mighty is your name in all the earth. Great and amazing are your deeds, O Lord God the Almighty. Just and true are your ways, O King of the nations. Who will not fear you, O Lord, and glorify your name? You, O Lord, are holy, are King of the nations. Every tribe will come and worship you, for your righteousness has been revealed. Worthy are you, O God, to receive glory, honor, and power. For you have created all things, and for your pleasure, your utmost pleasure, they are and were created. Contend with those who contend with us, Lord. Fight against those who fight us. Take up shield and armor and rise up to defend me. Unsheathe spear and javelin against my pursuers. Tell me, I am your salvation. Let those who seek my life be shamed and humiliated. Let those who plot my ruin be treated in disgrace. Let them be like chaff in the wind, driven by the Lord's angel. Let their way be dark and slippery, with the Lord's angel in pursuit. For they laid a trap for me without cause. Without cause they dug a pit for me. Let the ruin savage them suddenly. Let them be caught in their own trap and fall into their utter ruin. But my soul will delight in the Lord, rejoicing in his salvation. Every inch of my being declares, O Lord, who is like you? You save the poor from those too strong for them, the poor and the needy from those who exploit them. false witnesses suddenly come forward, interrogating me about things I know not. They repay good with evil. I am left bereaved. For when they were ill, I donned sackcloth, made myself suffer with fasting, prayer surging in my chest. I went about as if it were my own friend, my own brother, bowed in gloom, as if mourning from my mother. But when I stumbled, they swarmed in glee. Wretches suddenly swarmed around me, tearing at me without cease. With a vile mocking leer, they gnashed their teeth at me. How long, O Lord, will you look on? Save me from their onslaught, my precious life from lions. I will thank you before a great assembly. I will praise you before a mighty throng. Do not let my treacherous enemies gloat over me, or those who hate me without a cause narrow their eyes. For they do not speak words of peace. They devise treacherous schemes against the harmless of the land. Their mouths open wide against me. Aha! Aha! Our eyes have seen it. You have seen it, Lord. Do not remain silent. O Lord, do not be far from me. Awake and rise to my defense. Contend for me, my Lord, my God. Vindicate me in your justice, Lord, my God. Do not let them gloat over me. Do not let them tell themselves, aha, as we wished. Do not let them say, we have swallowed him up. Let those who gloat at my misfortune be altogether shamed and disgraced. Let those who boast over me don shame and humiliation. May those who delight in my vindication sing and rejoice. May they say, great be the Lord who delights in his servant's success. Then my tongue express your justice, your praise all day long. Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord is risen upon you. For behold, a darkness shall cover the earth, and deep darkness the people. But the Lord will arise over you, and his glory will be seen upon you. The Gentiles shall come to your light, and kings to the brightness of your rising. Lift up your eyes all around and see. They all gather together. They come to you. Your sons shall come from afar, and your daughters shall be nursed at your side. Then you shall see and become radiant, and your heart shall swell with joy, because the abundance of the sea shall be turned to you. The wealth of the Gentiles shall come to you. The multitude of camels shall cover your land. The dromedaries of Midian and Ephah, all those from Sheba, shall come. They shall bring gold and incense, and they shall proclaim the praises of the Lord. Behold, the Lord's hand is not shutting, that he cannot save, nor his ears heavy, that he cannot hear. But your iniquities, your acts of dishonor, your sins, your rebellions have separated you from your God. And your sins have hidden his face from you, so that he will not hear. For your hands are defiled with blood, and your fingers with iniquity. Your lips have spoken lies, and your tongue has muttered perversity. No one calls for justice, nor do any plead for truth. They trust in empty words and speak lies. They conceive evil and bring forth iniquity. They hatch viper's eggs and weave the spider's web. He who eats of their eggs dies, and from that which is crushed, a viper breaks out. But come, let us reason together. Do your sin be as red as scarlet, it shall become as white as snow. Do Though they be as dark as crimson, it shall be as pure as wool. For I will forgive your iniquities, and your transgressions I will remember no more. And in that day, no weapon formed against you shall prosper, and every tongue that rises against you in judgment, you shall condemn. And when the enemy comes in, like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord will raise up a standard against them.